In this video, I will show you how to make account animation with Blender in its most basic form. You can use this technique in many areas. You can use this method in digital clocks, three-dimensional comparison videos, and you can even use this feature to make a timer, countdown, or count forward. Of course, there is no limit to creativity. Let's open our new project. To start our project, we will use the cube, which is the starting point of Blender. But our focus will not be on this cube. Our focus will be on the geometry nodes. In a moment, I will show you how to open it and what we can do on it. There are systems in Blender where we can see multiple windows at the same time. So we can do what we want through many windows without being tied to a single window. In order to open the geometry nodes, we need to split the window in two. Right-click on this line at the bottom of the window and select Horizontal Split. If we had chosen the Vertical Split option, there would have been a vertical split. But with Horizontal Split, we can open another window horizontally. You will see a line following the mouse cursor. This allows us to specify from where the window will be split. We can split the window by clicking anywhere. We now have two separate workspaces. On the top side, we can work with the three-dimensional view, and on the other side, we can work with geometry nodes. Let's immediately open the geometry nodes editor. I click on this arrow and select geometry node editor. We use the geometry node editor to program our objects by providing a node-based interface. Let's select our object and click on the new button. Look, nodes have been added here. We call them nodes. Here you will see an input and an output option. I select the one on the left and click the delete button on the keyboard. I delete this one. We don't need this one. We have a few nodes to add. Under the Add menu, I'm going to select Utility under Text. I'm going to add the String to Curves option here, and we're going to add a value. Again, from the same place under Utilities, under Text, I select Value to String. We need to add this value to the Value node. I'm going to grab this and drag it here and look. You'll already see a plus icon on the cursor. When I release the mouse, such a search box will open. I just need to type value here. I select it and drop it on the stage. Then I connect the string value here. And then I connect the curve instances option to geometry. If we select all of these and press the comma button in the numlock section, it will be centered like this. Look, when we do these operations, pay attention to the scene. You will see a zero value here. The appearance of the zero value here indicates that we are continuing successfully. This is how we assign our cube to a value, but it is now horizontal. We just need to rotate it 90 degrees on the x-axis. Look, it is now vertically in front of us. We can change the zero value here by increasing the value. Whatever is written in the value section, we need to see that text in this field. I'm shifting the zero value to the right. And as I shift it to the right, whatever value the value has, it shows us that value above. If we were scrolling to the left, it would start playing minus after zero and show us the numbers with minus value. Therefore, we can give the increasing number animation with this logic. We can change this value by adding keyframes to the value, that is, by animating it. We can see the change of this value as an animation. I change this value to zero and right-click and select Insert Keyframe. When the timeline was at one, it inserted the keyframe here. I'm moving the timeline to the end. Blender has created a timeline for us, which is 250 by default. So, the last frame is frame 250. When I'm at 250, this is an animation going from 0 to 100, so I'm typing 100 here. I press Enter, see this is 100, but I have to right-click and say Insert Keyframe again. I move the timeline to the left, so I move it to the beginning, and I play it back. Pay attention here. When I play it, it starts from 0, and it reaches 100 until it reaches frame 250. But if you notice, the animation starts slowly, gets to its fastest point in the middle, and slows down again towards the end. Look, it's at 50. We can see that it slows down after 50, especially after 80. This is usually due to the default interpolation settings in the animation keyframes. By default, Blender uses Bezier to interpolate between keyframes. This causes the animation to slow down at the start and end points, as we just saw. We can fix this with the graph editor. Let's select the value value. See, when I select the value value, it will be white around it. Let's narrow this down a little bit so that we can control the graph editor in a much better way. I need to change the window here with graph editor. See, with value selected, you will already see the slope here. Let's center this like this. Again, I can see the keyframes instantly by pressing the comma key from the keyboard. See, this is the reason for the slowness at the beginning and at the end. There is a slope at the end in the same way as at the beginning. Let's select our keyframes. To fix this problem, I select both keyframes. Under the key menu, I go to interpolation mode and I select linear here. When I select this, look, the curves there straighten out. It becomes a straight line. I come back to the 3D viewport screen. I move the timeline back to the beginning and play it back. And notice that when I play it back, we won't see the slowness at the beginning and at the end. What we can notice here as a result of the application of linear interpolation is that the numbers are increasing more consistently. So from 0 to 100, we can see that there is equal spacing between all the seconds. But whether the beginning is fast or the end is slow, you can still make such adjustments through the graph editor. Right now, we only see whole numbers. By increasing the decimal option here, we can also see the values after the point. For example, I make it 1, see when I make it 1, we will be able to see the part after 0. You can see how it is by playing this here. I can do 2, I can do 3, I can do 4. You can do it according to what you want to do. That's it for this video. In this video, I showed how to make number counting animations with Blender. I hope it was useful. See you in the next tutorial.